So, are artificial sweeteners safe? Well, science doesn't always agree. Let's talk about the possible effects of artificial sweeteners on your health. Scientists disagree about the relationship between artificial sweeteners and cancers, including lymphomas, leukemias, bladder, and brain cancer, as well as the relationship between chronic fatigue syndrome, Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease, multiple sclerosis, autism, systemic lupus, and the use of artificial sweeteners. All of these conditions have been anecdotally related to the consumption of artificial sweeteners, but we don't have large studies that prove that artificial sweeteners contribute to these diseases. My biggest concern with artificial sweeteners is just that, they're artificial. And whenever you're consuming something that nature doesn't make, your body has to deal with it in a different way, and it can become a toxin in your body. So what I have suspected for many years is that artificial sweeteners will actually change the way your body deals with its glucose metabolism. Well, anytime you eat something sweet, whether it's really sugar or it's artificial, the receptor sites on your tongue will tell your hypothalamus that you're going to be getting sugar. So the hypothalamus expects to be getting glucose soon. And when you consume an artificial sweetened drink or food and do not actually consume those calories, your body releases stored sugar through the fight or flight mechanism to feed your hypothalamus. Now, observing so many young people who consume diet beverages is that artificial sweeteners don't really seem to help them lose weight. Now, it may in the beginning if they're replacing those sugar calories with negative calories, but it really doesn't help them lose weight in the long run. And that's because artificial sweeteners increase the incidence of insulin resistance, which contributes to body fat storage and obesity. Studies find that when you load a person, meaning you give them a drink that is either artificially sweetened or a sugar drink, and then measure their blood, the resultant rise in insulin and glucose is the same whether they drink something with artificial sweetener or real sugar. And that's because of this hypothalamic effect on controlling glucose metabolism. So when you're messing with your hypothalamus with artificial sweeteners, and you keep teasing it that it's going to be getting sugar and it has to keep releasing stored sugar in order to fuel its response to what you've promised it, you're eventually going to become insensitive to the high levels of insulin floating around and have more and more trouble losing weight, storing more body fat, especially around your middle. Now, studies have also seen the same effect with children. Children who consume artificial sweeteners are more likely to have issues with obesity and lipid metabolism, that's their cholesterol, as well as insulin sensitivity issues. They found that when children consume artificial sweeteners versus regular sweeteners before a meal, that they still consume the same amount of calories. They make up for the lack of calories from the artificial sweetener and consume the amount of calories they would have consumed if they had eaten the sugar. In fact, it seems that when people use artificial sweeteners, because they're so very sweet, people have decreased sensitivity to sweetness. And the less sensitive you are to sweetness is one of the indications of insulin resistance. Because artificial sweeteners are just too sweet, they actually promote an increase in your appetite and increase your food consumption over time. So you're really not saving any calories. Not that I'm promoting drinking sugared drinks. I believe you should be drinking beverages that are not sweetened at all and save those calories for foods that have nutritious benefits. And artificial sweeteners are potentially toxic. We do know that people who consume artificial sweeteners may experience increase in headaches, liver damage, cancer, brain damage, and damage to their unborn infants. So let's compare the different artificial sweeteners and see if they're safe. Saccharin. It's the first artificial sweetener discovered in 1879. It's in the tiny pink packets. Saccharin is 300 times sweeter than sugar, and it's used to sweeten various products, including soft drinks and baked goods, jams, chewing gum, canned fruit, candy, dessert toppings, salad dressing. It's also used in cosmetic products, toothpaste, mouthwash, lip gloss, vitamins, and medication. Saccharin has been shown to cause cancer and can be toxic to your liver. Aspartame. It was the first approved in 1981 as a tabletop sweetener. It's in the blue packets. In 1996, it was approved as a general purpose sweetener in foods and drinks. It's 200 times sweeter than sucrose. And aspartame is toxic. It's been the most controversial of all the artificial sweeteners. First, because of the carcinogenic potential when aspartame exposure occurs during gestation, meaning if the pregnant woman consumes aspartame, it's more likely that her child will develop cancer. And second, because the toxic dosage is at ADI, the acceptable daily intake, what's considered safe for humans, so you don't have to consume a lot of aspartame to cause damage. Aspartame can cause brain damage, and that's because it's metabolized into phenylalanine, especially when exposed in utero. Aspartame has also been associated with headaches, particularly migraines, and a study done on newborn rodents shows that exposure to aspartame caused hypothalamic neuronal necrosis, meaning nerves in the hypothalamus died due to being exposed to aspartame in the utero. While we haven't seen the same effect in non-human primates, I don't believe it's worth taking the chance with your unborn child. Acesulfame K was discovered in 1967. It was used to decrease the bitter aftertaste of aspartame. It's 200 times sweeter than sugar. Acesulfame K's toxicity is dose-related and can produce genetic damage. Now, sucralose was discovered in 1976. It's in the yellow packet. It's 600 times sweeter than sugar and was approved in 92 to be used in 15 different food categories. As for sucralose's toxicity, it seems to shrink the thymus, not directly, but because of nutritional deficits due to reduced food intake, which is a problem because your thymus programs your immune system, protecting you from disease and cancer. NEOTAME is the newest artificial sweetener, a derivative of aspartame. It's 7,000 to 13,000 times sweeter than sugar and was approved as a general purpose sweetener in 2002 by the FDA and can now be found in multiple products. So far, it has no known toxicity. In my professional opinion, if it's artificial food, we're going to eventually find out that it has some kind of toxic effect in the body. So regular use of artificial sweeteners can possibly be damaging to your cells, your DNA, and definitely can cause issues with insulin resistance. So consuming artificial sweeteners is not a good way to lose weight. It's a way to sweeten beverages because you've learned to drink them sweet. So my suggestion is that you start using less sweetener until you can learn to drink things that aren't sweet at all. And you'll find that your taste for sweetness becomes much more refined and you need a lot less sweetener of any kind in order to perceive sweetness. And that's when your insulin receptors become the most sensitive. Now you can learn a lot more about how to reverse insulin resistance in my hormone reboot training. A study was done testing sweet perception, and the subjects were both diabetics and non-diabetics. Real sugar was put in water in different amounts in each glass, from no sugar at all to multiple tablespoons of sugar per glass. And what they found is the more insulin resistant you were, with full-blown diabetes being the most insulin resistant, the less likely you could even taste the sugar in the water. Only people with healthy insulin receptors with normal insulin sensitivity and healthy glucose metabolism can perceive the minutest amount of sugar in water. So if you are blinding your taste receptors with doses, high doses of artificial sweeteners, meaning you're drinking it constantly, you're basically needing more and more sweetness to perceive taste than something that is sweet. And you're going to have much more issues with glucose metabolism, decreased sensitivity of your insulin receptors, and increased risk of developing insulin resistance and potentially type 2 diabetes, as well as obesity. So steer clear of artificial sweeteners. If you use them judiciously. And if you're pregnant, avoid them at all. Please check out my next video for more health tips.